I think that we did get stopped out on that second entry to the tick. Let's see if they can push this, if they can push the price into the support level. Next support level sitting at around 36.51. That's right where the second target is sitting. Right now, nothing we can do. The whole number is always a tricky area to trade from. And when the stop is sitting at around the whole number, sometimes noise will stop you out. Again, nothing we can do here. The stop is still sitting at 96. Let's see if we can hit the first target. And then we can pull down the stop loss. And then let's see if they can push this into the support level to get the second target. Okay, stop to break even. Again, second target is sitting at 3650. That is at around the next support level. That is between 49 and 52. We can eliminate these lines. It would be normal to get a retracement here back into resistance. So let's see if we can hold the area here without without hitting our protective stop loss here. If we hit the stop loss, I will be looking for a re-entry. Again, nothing we can do here. Stop is sitting at break even. Slow price action again. Again, if we hit the stop loss here, we'll be looking for a re-entry. We are trading above resistance. We still have the proper picture on the higher time frame to short the market. If we get a new pivot on the chart, we will be able to pull down the stop loss by a few ticks here. But we need to test the low again, the lower low. $63 will probably give us a pivot. Again, nothing we can do here. We will need a new pivot on the chart, a new lower high in order to pull down the stop by a few ticks. We probably need 63 to get a lower high on the chart, or maybe even 62. Again, nothing we can do here. The stop is in place. Trent is currently down. Let's see if we can break 61 to test the next support level. Maybe even breaking the next support level and going into 2 days low. We have a lower high on the chart. Stop at 77. Let's see if we can break 61. There we go. Higher time frame resistance area. Pull that down into 76. Again, stop is sitting at 77. Bit price has to go down. There we are breaking 59. Nothing we can do with no regards to the stop loss. Stop is still sitting at 77. We will need a new pivot in order to pull down the stop loss. But let's see if we can hit the next target without getting a pivot on the chart. They need to pull down the bid price in order to break 56. Let's see what we get. 68 will give us a new pivot, a new lower low on the chart. Let's see if we can hold the higher time frame resistance area. Resistance is sitting at 76. If we get a new lower high on the chart, we'll pull down the stop loss by a few ticks. But we will need to test the lower low again. All we can do right now is just holding on. Nothing we can do. We have seen some slow price action on crude for the last couple of weeks. Fifty-seven will give us a lower high on the chart, so we can pull down the stop loss. Again, stop is still sitting at 77. We will need a lower high on the chart in order to pull down the stop loss. Okay, pull down the stop loss. Stop is sitting at 17, locking in 10 ticks per contract. Let's see if we can hit the second target here. Getting some really slow price action. Can pull down the resistance area. Resistance is sitting at 69. Okay. Thank you, Robert. Not a perfect day today, but you never know what price will do. I think that we had some bad luck here on the second entry. And if you look back At this year, crude is not behaving, not giving the normal moves. Will not be looking for a re-entry here on a pullback. Let's take a look at the trading chart at the higher time frame. We have a we have broken a support level, so it would be normal to get a pullback here in this area. But with today's outcome, I prefer to hold on to the trade and see if we can hit the last target here to reduce the losses of today. Again, normal pullback, testing the broken prior support area. Fifty-seven will probably give us a new lower low on the chart. Again, 57 will give us a lower low on the chart. If we can test 42 again, I will pull down the stop loss. the next support level on the chart will be 2 days low. We have a new lower low on the chart. If we can test the low again, we will get a lower high on the chart and we will pull down the stop. If you want to add contracts, we have a valid setup with entry at 48 right now. Double resistance at 59. We probably need 44 or even 43 to get a lower high on the chart. Let's see if we can break 42. then going into 2 days low. Almost an hour into the trade. Again, we need a pivot on the chart in order to pull down the the stop. It is probably safe to lock in another 10 ticks. But let's wait for a pivot. Don't know if 43 will give a pivot on the chart. Let's see if they can try it again. Don't know if we. I think that we will need 43 on the chart to get a pivot at 59. Again, it is probably safe to lock in another 10 ticks without getting the pivot in place. To lock in 20 ticks on the last contract. We are getting some troubles here at around the 50 area. I don't want to give that much back. If we are breaking 59, momentum will shift. Okay. Let's do the daily recap here. We are heading into the US lunch break. But we don't have a price action right now. Let's take over the trading day of today. Let's remove the drawing objects at the open of the trading room. Trend was up. No setup on this retracement here. We eventually broke. Broke a support level, and we even broke a second support level that was sitting at 56. First setup for today, losing 16 ticks per contract on this setup. Right after that, we broke. We broke resistance. No retracement in our way up. We needed a retracement testing support. There was no retracement. After that, we broke the support level that we had sitting at 93. We got the first setup. Losing 16 ticks. Second A second entry appeared on the chart. Stopped out to the tick, losing again 16 ticks, and having to take a momentum trade, a third setup from the same area. I think that we had some bad luck here on the second trade, getting stopped out to the tick. Tough price action for today, tight trading range. If you look at price, about 80 ticks. Any questions for today, guys? Before I shut down the room. Okay, Robert. Okay, guys, no questions. We'll call it for today. Losing trading day for today. Let's see what the market will give us tomorrow. Okay, guys, take care and see you all back tomorrow.